these items refer to effective alteration of existing height restrictions and demolition of four heritage buildings. Because of the Merge Dairy mega project, which calls for three giant conch towers all over 80 stories tall. What we have predominantly now along the stretch of King Street West is very human scale buildings of 5 to 6 stories, many of them lovely old warehouse buildings representing early 1900s Toronto. I feel cities need diversity of architecture to retain their character and to preserve their past. They need both old and new buildings. However, Toronto is losing too many old buildings to these new skyscraping condos. That particular stretch of King Street West already has the tall buildings of Metro Hall in the south, large complex of condos on John Street, south of King, the TIFF condos, and more condo towers further west along King Street. It all starts to look depressingly the same. Whether towers are built to look like sculptures, twist left, twist right, or appear golden, whatever. However, a condo tower is a condo tower, and we have enough on King Street West. Tall, towering buildings can make people feel very small and insignificant in an area that should stay pleasant for walking. Corridors, tall condos do not make for an appealing walk. Furthermore, the height restrictions are altered for the particular King Street properties mentioned earlier. A dangerous precedent could be set. Not only do we get Mr. Mervish's tall towers, but other developers rush in, wanting to build even more skyscrapers and further increase the density in this community. The Mervish proposal for some 2,700 additional residential units is mind-boggling. That section of King Street West already suffers severe traffic congestion. We know that the TTC is almost always crowded now and horrific during rush hour. And those people with 2,700 units, they're not all going to be walking everywhere. They'll be using the TTC, they'll be driving as well. Also, we all know the city has problems with aging infrastructure, problems with power blackouts and sewers during storms. Yet, we want to create more strain on worn-out systems with this proposed population influx. The second item, 28.3, calls for the demolition of 266, 276, 284, and 322 King Street West. These solid buildings are supposed to be a distinctive part of the designated King Street Island Heritage Conservation District. The Reed Building, 266, I understand, is one of the first warehouse buildings reclaimed by Ed Mervish, who renovated old warehouses in this district and gave them new life. Now his son wants to demolish it. The Princess of Wales Theatre, also doomed to demolition under this proposal, is a fully functioning theatre that is very well known and has drawn many patrons to its site. None of these buildings are dilapidated, none of them are condemned. They're large, solid, well-built structures that suit this area, and yet Mr. Mervish wants to obliterate them. They will be raised, a part of Toronto's history, long forever. What would we have if construction on this mega project was allowed to happen? We would have constant noise, construction mess, traffic disruption, giant gaping holes in a popular tourist destination, a great way to discourage tourists and celebrities from visiting this part of the entertainment district for some time. Even more traffic chaos. It was certainly to block the restaurant and pub business in the area, particularly generated by the Toronto International Film Festival. Locals too want to avoid construction mess, making it an economic challenge for most nearby businesses. I feel for members of council to keep up the existing height restrictions of the designated King Street West properties intact and to prevent demolition of historic buildings or features on this stretch of King Street West.
Can you finish up, please?
Yes. There are many citizens of Toronto who still believe in retaining heritage buildings and keeping our city livable and manageable by controlling self-development density and infrastructure resources. The official plan should be applied judiciously to respect our distinct communities and heritage districts. We don't have the mountains, the ocean, the scenery of Vancouver, but we do have our diverse neighborhoods that represent different cultures and our architecture. Let's not ruin that by creating more.